It's forecast to be one of the worst days that Sydney's train network has seen, with a strike tomorrow disrupting the busiest rail lines in the city. The T1 Western and North Shore line will run with very few services as the rail union tries to defend its decision to boycott trains, even using graffiti as an excuse.
It's clear Sydney is fed up with a rail network crippled by strikes.
I'm sick of our people being used as political pawns in this union dispute.
I understand there are a lot of people very frustrated and angry, and I'm one of them.
The dispute between the rail union and government turned plain bizarre today. The union refusing to drive some trains because they were graffitied.
Severe graffiti, swear words, all the rest of it, would be enough to say that train shouldn't go.
37 trains from Campbelltown, Leppington, Blacktown, Auburn, Hornsby, North Sydney were, according to the RTBU, either not clean enough or unsafe to drive, even though they drove them just yesterday without issue.
It's all about making life extremely difficult for the senior managers and the bureaucrats and the government.
Tomorrow, it's only going to get worse. Services will run at best every half an hour on the T1 North Shore and Western lines. From 10 a.m. to 4 p.m, railway staff will strike across the state from Gosford to Blacktown, Richmond, West Ryde, Toongabie, St Mary's, Warunga, Chatswood. Around 180 suburbs and towns will be with minimal trains. Chris Minns is being pressured to get the union to scrap it.
The strikes at the moment are not working. I don't want them to go ahead.
So you're saying just to the unions, just give up?
No, I don't think that. I think that this industrial dispute and these strikes are not going to shift the government, and I think they need to come to an end.
It's clear everybody's patience has run out here. The Labor opposition is furious at the union and they want this dispute resolved, while the government is hoping to make all of it about Chris Minns. A Liberal attack ad, along with a government frustrated it can't get its way.
The state of New South Wales is losing millions and millions of dollars because of this terrible industrial campaign.
Without a circuit breaker, the industrial action is tipped to extend into September. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.